With this new AI feature in Photoshop, you can generate your desired results by providing your required images. So let's take a look at how it works. First things first, this feature is only available in the Photoshop beta at the moment. So in the Creative Cloud app, go to the apps, navigate to the beta apps, and here you can download the Photoshop beta. Alright, I'm inside the Photoshop beta, and I have an image here. The guy is holding a file folder. What I want is to replace this folder with this particular briefcase. I'll select this folder with the object selection tool. There's some portion of the file that can't be selected separately. So I'll select the lasso tool and manually mark the area. It doesn't have to be perfect. I'll also mark some area here for the handle of the briefcase. That's it. Now you can either click on this generative fill from the contextual bar or go to the edit and here you can find the generative fill option. You can type some prompt in here, but it's gonna generate some random results which we don't want in this case. To generate a subject of a specific style, there's this new feature called a reference image. You can simply click here and select your required image that you want to generate. It's also recommended to put the description of the subject. Click on generate. And there's our briefcase. It has generated 3 options. You can generate more options if you want. This one's better. If you take a look, the results are quite close to my reference image, and this is a brand new feature. Imagine its power in the upcoming updates. Now let's try one more example. Before we proceed further, if this video is providing any value to you, then please take a moment to like and subscribe. I have this image where I want this shirt to be replaced with this shirt. I'll select the object selection tool, and it has selected the whole person, but we want to select the shirt only. So I'll select the lasso tool, set it to subtraction, and simply mark the area that I don't want to be included in my selection. I'll also deselect the arms and fingers, but I'll be a bit careful for this because generative fill is not very effective on the fingers at the moment. Alright, now as we have selected the shirt, I'll click on generative fill. In the reference image, I'll select the new shirt design. I'll put the description, hit generate, and there we go. It has generated some great results. If you take a look, the generated image is not as high quality as the original image. Adobe has also introduced another feature, which is this enhance image button at the top left of the thumbnail. It'll enhance the resolution, and you can see the difference. If I open the history, this is the first low resolution result. And this is the enhanced version. Reference image is a great feature, and this is really gonna change the game of AI image generation. Try it yourself and share your experience in the comments below. If this video was helpful, please give it a like and subscribe. Your support is much appreciated. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.